All right, welcome back to Valley Pura Vida. Now, the Cameron County Education Initiative is a nonprofit school in the Rio Grande Valley that helps to provide local students with bright academic and employment futures. And their team survived various difficulties brought forth by the pandemic. But now they've reopened their locations in Valley Baptist's Edelstein building. They've actually got a career training center where attendees do not pay for services. Plus, they offer daycare in the hospital on top of various forward-thinking innovation opportunities and leadership resources. So our crew dropped by their facility to learn all about what you need to know. Check it out.
See, Cameron County Education Initiative, or what we call CCEI, is a nonprofit career school licensed by the Texas Workforce Commission. We're committed to helping families thrive in our community, and we do so by providing zero debt career training in high demand careers. Actually, it's a great story. After the pandemic, we struggled like everyone else, and then we found that our building was sold, and we just kind of stored everything and waited it out to see if a miracle would happen, and sure enough, a miracle did. Thanks to some industry leaders in the community, we were able to store our equipment and reopen at Valley Baptist Medical Center at the Professional Edelstein Building. Got a great location. It's perfect for what we're trying to do. So we're able to provide zero debt training to our students either through WIOA, which is through the Texas Workforce Commission, through grants that we write here at the school. And this year we're very fortunate in that an angel investor donated a chunk of quite a significant amount of money so we can provide scholarships for our students. And we're working right now to get those matched through another donor. So between the grant and that foundation, we have 120 slots for interested individuals in our community to take advantage of this zero debt training, career training. So the beauty of this school is that we have amazing industry partners. We work with Dr. Diaz's office here, Dr. Brooks next door, Dr. Zamir, the hospital, Valley Day and Night, and numerous clinics throughout our community. And they help us. They help us by accepting our students during externships, helping them acquire jobs before they're certified so that they can continue going to school. A lot of our students are single moms or working moms or just recently unemployed, and we need to get them back to work. So we've got great partners that hire them through the process and work with us. And not only that, once they graduate, they help them grow even further and continue their education in the field or in the pathway. But our goal is twofold here with them. One, we know that our partners are in the medical community needs more staff. We know that. And if we're able to work with them to provide career placement, career training in those high demand areas, then it's a win for them and it's a win for our students. So tonight's a big night. Commissioner Avedis, representing labor from Austin, will be in town, and he's going to celebrate one of the grants it received. We're going to have grant-funded auto tech training and phlebotomy training in the evening. And the beautiful part of the phlebotomy training is we're right next to the hospital, so a lot of our students work at the hospital and in maintenance or in records. Some of them work in the cafeteria. They're able to come at night, earn an additional certification, and work their way up in the medical pathways. In our auto tech, we work with our local dealerships and we get uncertified automotive technicians and certify them so they can increase their earning capacity. They can visit our Facebook page if anyone wants any more information, or they can call our school. At CCEI, we accredit our success that we've had. Since reopening with our small class size, we limit our sizes to about 10. To our incredible teacher, and we just try to work with our students, and we know that everyone struggles, and so we work with them to ensure that we can serve their needs and work with workforce to get them the assistance they need to be successful.
Thank you to Dr. Rita for helping our community, and thank you to you for tuning in on Valley Pura Vida today. I'll see you next time.